Good morning, students. You are all know that your new academic session is started, but due to some reason we are not going in school. So that's why our school started a facility to provide you video online video classes, so that you can learn or understand the concept of your related subject. I am your computer teacher. My name is Surya Pachurkar. I teach you computer subject. Now this video is for class 6th. Your first chapter we will explain in this video. Your first chapter is computer fundamental. You have to see in this book. Your chapter first is computer fundamental. Now in this chapter we have to talk about the computer generations of computer. First we talk about what is computer. So you know very well the computer is electronic machine which we can accept the results input and process it and generate the output. We use computer for relevant results, accurate results, and that results we get very faster. That's why we are using computer. Now we have to talk about the generation of computer. In this chapter we have discussed about the generation of computer. When we talk about the generation means the technologies which computers are used in the years. The technology which the computer is used in the years, that is called the generation of computers. Now, in this chart, I am explaining to you, this is the types of generations. This is first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, and fifth generation. This is the generation of computers. This is the chart of generation of computer. Now we have to talk about the first generation of computer. First generation of computer is use vacuum tubes for generating or accepting inputs or generating output. This is the chart which explain to you the first generation of computer. Then the technology is used as vacuum tube, or the time period of this generation is 1940 to 1956. This is the generation of first generation of computer. Now in this generation of computer we have used vacuum tubes. See this type of vacuum tubes we are using in the first generation computer. The cylindric type vacuum tubes we are using. Now the technology is used vacuum tube. The time period is 1940 to 1956. Now we are discussing about the characteristics of this generation computer. This generation computer is used vacuum tubes. That's why this computer is too much heavy in weight. And it's too much bulky and it's taking a lot of space. Lot of space means it's taking a two or three rooms for occupied for one computer and generating output in a 1 or 2 days or within a week. It will take a too much time consuming. It generate lot of heat because of thousands of vacuum tubes we are used in it. That's why it generate lot of heat. It consumes more power. And we are difficult to handle this program. The one user cannot be handle this computer because the program is too much difficult in it. The programming is too much difficult for it. So this is the characteristics of first generation computer. The first generation computer having some examples. These are the some examples of first generation computer. It is ENIAC, EDWIC or UNIVIC. These are the first generation computers example. ENIAC, EDWIC or UNIVIC. ENIAC is the first electronic digital computer which is developed by the scientist of John. John scientist is developed this computer. ENIAC first digital electronic digital computer. Now we have talk about the next generation. Next generation computer is second generation of computer. This is the chart of second generation computer. Second generation computer, then the technology transistor is used in this generation, and the time period of this generation is 1956 to 1964. 1956 to 1964, we are using this generation computer. In this generation computer, we are using transistors. So, this generation is better than the first generation computer. First generation computer having characteristics, it's overcome the drawback of first generation computer. Like, they are small in size, less power consumption, use small space. The internal storage of this generation computer is high, more than the first generation computer. For input, for giving input, we are using punch card in it. Punch card. For giving the input, we are using punch card in it. Well, the technology which we are using transistors for giving input, the technology is used punch cards. So these are the some characteristics of second generation computer. The example of second generation computers are, these are the example of second generation computer: ENIAC 1401, IBM 700, CDC 160. These are the some examples of second generation computer: ENIAC 1401, IBM 700 and CDC 160. These are the some examples of second generation computer. Now we overcome this drawback in third generation of computer. Now third generation of computer we have designed for us, it's clearly see the drawbacks which we face in first or second generation computer, it's overcome in the third generation of computer. So this is the chart of third generation computer. Third generation computer, the technology is used integrated circuit, or the time period of third generation computer is 1964 to 1971. This is the third generation computer chart. Now, the generation, which generation third we are using, they have some characteristics. So the characteristics which overcome the drawback of first or second generation computer, that characteristics we will discuss. It is very small and cheaper in cost. It is not so much expensive. It takes a small space, not more spacious. It is taking a less space. It is, the power consumption is very low. It's not generate a lot of heat. It's not generated the lot of heat. The main advantage of this generation computer is we have provide input with the help of keyboard. Now the keyboards are established, or we have to give the input from the keyboard and generated output and see the output on the monitor. So this is the main advantage of third generation computer. This is the main advantage of third generation computer, that we are using for giving input by the keyboard and generating output and see the output on the monitors. It is more effective than the first or second generation computer. The example of third generation computers are IBM 360, ICL 1900 and VAX 750. These are the some examples of third generation computer. Now, in this generation, we have used operating system so that all the programs are run together. In this generation as well, we have used operating system so that all programs are run together. Now, the transistors or the ICs, integrated circuits, this two technology we are using in a different machines as well, like washing machine, radio and TV. These are the some or another example of this technology where we used. Now we talking about the fourth generation computer. This is the fourth generation of computer. This is the chart of fourth generation computer. This generation which we used nowadays as well. This is the time period of fourth generation computer 1971 to till present. The technology which is used by the fourth generation computer, it's microprocessor. Microprocessor. This is the technology. So now in fourth generation computer, we have discussed some characteristics which is overcome by the first, second or third generation computer. Main advantage of this generation computer, it is small in size. It is handheld computers as well. We can take it from one space to the another space. Okay. Now the example of this generation computers are we using these computers at home as well as in office, like laptop, PCs, laptop. These are the some examples of this generation. It is so much easier to handle the program in it. We can find more effective and reliable results in it. It generate a less of heat and occupy the less space. This is the fourth generation computer. Main advantage of this generation computers are networked. They established a network from one computer to another to share the data or resources. For sharing the data or resources, this generation computer establishing a link or they establishing a network. This is the advantage of this generation computer. So this is some examples of this generation computer is HP 9000, IBM 4300 and ICL 2900. These are the example of this generation. First microprocessor is developed by the Intel Corporation. Intel Corporation has developed first microprocessor, that is called Intel 4004. It is developed by the Intel Corporation in 1971. In 1971, first microprocessor was developed. So this is our fourth generation which we discussed in this video. Now the last generation which is still going on in development, that is called fifth generation of computer. In fifth generation of computer, we have talking about the technology that is called AI, artificial intelligence. It is called artificial intelligence. The main purpose of artificial intelligence is that the computer which we are using, they think their own and they do their work their own and then behave like a human beings. That is the main advantage or main purpose of artificial intelligence. Now in the today's scenario, we have established one application that is the very good example of artificial intelligence is called voice recognition. When we use any type of application which is listen your voice and behave or repeat the thing or take that instruction and repeat the same task and perform that task accurately, that is called the system which is developed by the artificial intelligence. So the voice recognition system is the main example of artificial intelligence. Now saying it's the working on this generation is still going on, the areas where the artificial intelligence is used, that areas are scientific areas where the scientists are use this type of generation. Next in robotics we are using this, and in the defense also we are using artificial intelligence. The example of artificial intelligence is CRAE. CS300 series is the example, or the robotics where the robots we are created this, it is the example of artificial intelligence, or it is the example of fifth generation computer. So In this chapter, we have discussed about the five generation of computers. First, we talk about the first generation computer, that is from the technology which we used in it. It is vacuum tubes. Now you have to see how vacuum tubes are looked. It's like this. Vacuum tube, the generation of this is 1940 to 1956. Now the second generation of computer which we are using over here, that is called the transistors, or the time period of this generation is 1956 to 1964. Now this is the third generation of computer where we use integrated circuits. It's look like this, integrated circuit. The generation of this is time period is 1964 to 1971. Now this is the fourth generation of computer where we used microprocessor. Microprocessor, the generation of this time period of this generation is 1971 to till present, is going on. And the fifth generation computer are used robotics. Robots, which are we are not using that robots, but the voice recognition system is the example of artificial intelligence. It is still in development. So this is my first chapter video, which I discuss about all the main focus of all the generation of computers. So this chapter is done. Now in the next video we have discussed about the next chapter. Thank you.